How to create the best product ever. In this video, I'm going to share with you the two simple steps to create the greatest product ever. Now, this is something, alhamdulillah, I've been involved in for a long time in terms of product development, and I've tried to simplify it for you. And so by the end of this, I think you'll be on your journey to doing exactly the same. Now, this is kind of split into two parts. The first part is to do with the product itself, and the second thing is to do with the process of making it great. So this kind of brings me back to a time when I was a part of iEra, and when I was there was two amazing speakers and du'at that we have there. We have many actually, but one of them was Abdurrahim Green, and the other one was Hamza Zortzis. And so these two guys both had their own dawah courses. And so they came to me and they said, okay, we want you to take the dawah courses and we want you to make them amazing. So me and another colleague of mine, Steve, we sat down and we started to focus heavily on making this course amazing. Now, the two elements that I think you need to focus on, like I said, the first is to do with the product, the second is the process. In regards to the product itself, the number one thing is that it must add value. It must add value to those using the product. Now, when we say add value, what we're basically saying is that it must solve a problem because value is created when problems are solved. And it basically takes you from a state of before to the after that we're always talking about. So, for example, in this case, someone who before has no idea how to give da'wah, meaning tell people about Islam, call non-Muslims to Islam. He has no idea, he has no confidence, and like really has a desire for it. And the after is like where they're very, very confident, they understand exactly what needs to be done, and then they go out and do it. So this was the before and after that we need to go through. So whenever we're talking about a product, you need to be thinking about your before and after. You need to be thinking about the transformation you want to take them from. And two, you want to think about the problem that it solves, and then you want to make sure that you get that right. This is called the product market fit, getting the problem right with the people that you're serving and the solution that's there. So this is the first thing. Now, the second point, which I think is even more important, and I think it will really help with the first point, is actually the process of improving. So when it comes to the process of improving, the main thing you need to do is iterate the product. You need to iterate the product. So let me give you an example of what happened. So we went out, me and Steve, along with the help of all the du'at and stuff, and we created this brand new course, taking the best elements from all the courses, taking the experience I had, Steve had, and putting it all together into this amazing product. Now, if we had left it at that point and just said, this is the product, off we go, fantastic, we're happy. I don't think the product would have been as amazing as it was. So what we did after this is we went out and we delivered it. So we delivered it once. And while we were delivering it, me and Steve, we were sitting in the audience and we were watching how the delivery happened. We were watching how the students were taking it in, what kind of interactions it was creating, the kind of understanding that the students were getting, and the students, they were getting some things completely wrong and they weren't understanding it at all. So what we did is we basically sat down after that course finished and said, you know what, in this part it didn't go so well, so why don't we add this here? And then in this part that went really well, how can we scale that up? And then we started to make different changes to it, and then it was like, okay, next week we're delivering the course again. So we then changed all the binders and we would only print a few. We changed the slides, we changed the delivery, we changed everything and said, right, let's go try that. And then the second week, we went and tried that stuff. And then we found, alhamdulillah, it worked really well. And then we found other things that didn't work. And we basically did this for week three, and then week four, and week five, and week six, and week seven. And every week, we were changing the binders, every week, we were changing the delivery, the approach, viewing everything. And I think we did that consecutively, probably about 20 weeks or 20 times. And you can imagine that after doing that 20 times and getting the live feedback and seeing how they were getting things, how they were not getting things, it completely transformed the product. And so after 20 weeks, you know, we ended up with a course which was totally different from the first course. You know, the 20 audiences that we went through, the major changes, this all came together to produce a product which had been iterated so many times with live feedback from the participants that it produced something which was truly, truly amazing. And so the way you can take this for your own product is exactly the same way, where you go off, you make something which you believe is amazing, and you go and deliver it. And once you deliver it, you test it with the market, you see how that works, and then you make changes. And then you deliver it again, and then you make changes, and then you deliver it again. And by the way, these changes don't need to be huge. It could just be very simple things where you think, okay, there's a break in understanding. How about if we show this picture? Or how about we if we say this in this way? Or how about if we introduce a case study, or if we introduce a story or an example? It could be absolutely anything. The main thing is that you actually look at how people are interacting with your product, look at how they're using it, look at what's working well, look at what's not working well, and really, really focus on bringing maximum value to the person. Now, of course, this is all underpinned by you having that high standard in your mind that I want to achieve a product which is truly amazing, which has true impact. And I promise you, if you get your product market fit right, if you keep reiterating, and if you have these high standards in your mind, then you will produce a product which is truly great, inshallah. I hope it helps. And of course, if you need any help with it, you can always get in touch with me. You can DM me, PM me, or whatever is easiest. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.